Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, it's gonna be a bit special today, but no drama, no worries. Before we carry on with this video, please subscribe to my channel. It makes me happy, at least a little bit. Activate the little bell if you want to see more of my video as well. And that's it. Follow me on Instagram as well. So you've seen by the title of the video today that is quite particular today. So I decided to do this video just because I do receive a lot of messages on Instagram asking me some brand, asking me if I want to try their fragrance, and saying, which I'm gonna talk about after, that they are doing the same thing as designer or luxury fragrance, but without the price. So, you know, I wanted to try it myself. So little disclaimer before, we are not talking at all about clones houses. This is completely different. I'm not a client of clone houses. I don't want to buy, I'm not looking to be a client neither, but I do respect those houses because some are doing nicely, you know, and I've got nothing to say about that, and this is not the purpose of the video. I personally prefer to work a bit more to get the fragrance I want in luxury, even if it's expensive, than getting something that is advertised to be exactly similar. Just it's a question of but we're not talking about that today. I'm not talking also about houses that are sampling famous fragrances for their public to try it, because you know it's very helpful, and sometimes when you don't want to buy the fragrance without trying it and you've got absolutely no way to do it, it's really interesting. So I'm not talking about that. Also not talking about people that are inspired by other fragrance, because this is totally fine. Like, I mean, we all inspire with something or someone in our life, and it's fine. And so this is definitely not that. What we're talking today is brand or society or people just saying that they pretend to do exactly the same fragrance, the same juice as a designer or a niche fragrance, and that you, when you buy luxury fragrance, are just buying the bottle and the brand, which is not true. So these people usually send me message, being like, oh hello, would you like to try a fragrance? We do source our ingredient at the same factory in Germany. I don't know where they say Germany. The same factory, same ingredient, and same factory and same quality. So this is definitely not true, because you just have to do a little research to see that where designer or niche are sourcing the ingredient and where they are producing the product. And this person has been telling me like very big brands and telling me they were sourcing them in Germany, which is, I know, not true. And would you think that a brand like a luxury brand would agree that those other brands are definitely copying and trying to get the market of this brand would agree to be in the same factory? No. So there's different types. Some are blending the same juice and they will have a totally different bottle, and some would have exactly the same bottle of the actual fragrance, the actual real one, which I think is, why? Like, it's disrespectful, completely disrespectful, like to get exactly the same bottle. And usually those person would slightly change the name, so the name would it doesn't mean anything anymore, and it's really like to get a little bit of the market of the luxury brand to make money on it, and I think it's not right. It's exactly like you're buying like a I would say like a not original designer bag, and it's exactly the same basically. So it's up to you, it's your choice. Some, you know, like why not? It is, well, but you know, totally up to you. I do also do this video because first of all, it's quite entertaining. Second, I was just very curious. And third, also, I don't think it's really like nice for perfumers. Like when we know that some designers, like perfumer designer, or are taking years to create a fragrance, and then suddenly those people taking the bottle and just, you know, taking the juice as well. I'm like, there's so many ingredients in this planet, so many things to create. You can be creative as you want, so it's okay to be inspired, but I mean, you can be a bit more creative and create your touch or something like that, I don't know. So I'm not going to show you the brand of the fragrance I bought, just because no drama here, and it's entertaining, so there's no need to be any drama. And also, like in the comment, I do trust you to not create a drama as well. It's just, you know, entertainment. First, so this is the little act. I don't show you the what is written here. They didn't took the name of the brand. They have their own brand, and this brand has been contacting me so many times on Instagram saying, oh, we have the same quality ingredient, exactly, blah, 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 blah. And I've been never answered. Sometimes I have been answering actually like a bit. Anyway, but you know, I was like, you don't know, maybe it's good, so let's try it. Maybe it was it. So I've paid this one around £15. The box look exactly the same as, oh, so yeah, basically it's, they say that it's basically Dior Sauvage. They don't advise it is, but they say that it smells exactly the same, and you've got the same bottle. So it's got the same box as Dior Sauvage, except it's not the same writing, and there's a different name on the packaging, which I'm not going to show you. The first thing I wanted to look at is the list of ingredients to see if it's okay. The list of ingredients is here, which is good and quite rare for those fragrance, you know. But you won't be able to see when you're looking at this list of ingredients in your box what Fragrantica shows, like the actual natural ingredient, because it will be called fragrance because it's just the composition of the solution of the perfume. So it will not be exactly the ingredient. The ingredient will be inside the name of fragrance, parfum, inside. So I wanted just to compare it to, for example, like a little Tom Ford. It's quite the same, to be honest. Like there's the same first ingredient. The first ingredient on the list is always the one that is the most present in the composition. So we've got alcohol, denat, the same. Then we've got fragrance, so that's where the ingredient should be. And then we've got water, so that's the same. We've got a bit the same. There's a bit more ingredient in the Tom Ford for sure, like at least like 10 more. But as I can see, there's nothing that should be really bad for you as far as I know of the ingredients. So, you know, so not very different. So it's not surprising, and it doesn't mean it's going to be good for you because you don't know what's inside the fragrance technically, what are the ingredients used and blah, blah, blah. Because this is just the solution list, basically. First of all, we're going to check the bottle. So let's open this. Okay, so I'm hiding the name, but it looks like this. So it really like a little bottle of Sauvage technically. So it looks much more lighter, but it's in glass, except the cap. And usually when you want to see something in genuine, look at the cap, because the cap says a lot. And usually the companies are like working on something quite solid and you know, quite different. It can be sometimes a bit like, you know, magnetic or stuff like that. And so the cap is usually quite, you know, it says a lot. And this one is just plastic. So says a lot again. The Dior one, as I remember, has got a little bee inside of the cap that you can have a look, that is actually really good. So this is a mark of luxury as well. You can see the attention to details, and this is what you're paying as well. I think the bottle is part of the juice too. I like to have a beautiful product, and those houses, that's why they're luxury. They show you a big attention to details, so you don't have the detail, blah blah blah. But apart from that, it looks a bit the same. I mean, I took a small size because I'm not going to use it after, obviously. I'm not a client of Sauvage, first of all, I need to say. This is not my favorite fragrance of Dior. I do prefer Fahrenheit, I do prefer Dior Homme range or something like that. Or the exclusive range, for example, but not a client of Sauvage. But you know, it's a nice fragrance as well. So just to give you like a little bit reminder of what Sauvage is, it's bergamot pepper, we've got lavender, vetiver, patchouli, labdanum, cedar, ambergris, ruddy notes. So it's kind of like a woody trail, slightly spicy, a touch of aromatic, so it smells clean and wants to balance it with something a bit more warmer in the dry down. So you know, it's a bit spicy as well, so with the pepper and everything. Yeah, that's it. So it's a nice, I would say, daytime fragrance. It's an easy one, I would say. So the first thing I can see as well when I'm turning the fragrance, and this is written made in China, and I'm laughing a lot when I see that, because the person that's been contacting me on Instagram has been clearly saying Germany. So, shows a lot. So then we're going to talk about this scent, which I think is the most important thing. So I've been spraying like a bit before the spray on here. And yesterday I've been retrying Sauvage again to compare it, to make sure my mind was fresh in there. So I don't have any Sauvage at home, but I know the scent since many years. So I will be able to do you a clear comparison on the two, that's for sure. Yeah, so I've tried this morning, I let it be dry down, and the only thing that I have to say is it's quite like tricky, like, because so at the beginning, when you first spray it, you can clearly smell the idea of Sauvage. Not exactly the same, but you clearly smell it. Like, this gives you an illusion that you have the fragrance for you. After 2 or 3 seconds, this starting to smell weird. And like acid, very acidic, lemony, but not a nice lemon, very acidic. And it really makes me think of the product to clean the window, or even the washing your little fairy, you know? And now, after a few times when I smell it, so it kind of disappeared as well, like it's not here anymore. And I think it's psychologic, but I'm starting to scratch myself. Maybe it's psychologic. You smell the woody undertone, but it really smells like the cleaning spray, so it's not nice. I mean, I paid £15 and I'm definitely sure I'm not going to wear it. Like, I mean, for free you can go to Dior and ask them for samples or things like that. I think they do smaller size as well, so smells very weird. I can't really smell it anymore. Just a little bit of that acidic smell, so there's nothing really comparable to the quality of Dior, that's for sure. Like, it's definitely, it smells like very synthetic, which is fine sometimes because fragrance is a good balance between synthetic and natural. But this smells extremely plasticky, like very plasticky. Like, I feel I'm in, I don't know, in a lab that is doing plastic or something, so it's not nice. It's not nice at all. But yeah, so my conclusion of this is there's nothing nice in that. Like, it's exactly when you buy a fake handbag and you have the logo that is slightly changed, you think it's not a lot, but it does look cheap. And with those fragrance, you smell cheap. Basically, it's not a good idea. Like I would say, like just wait a bit longer if you want a bottle of a luxury fragrance. Wait a little, and that's what I've done with my Tom Ford, for example. I've been waiting. I've been working more to get this fragrance, and once I got it, I was so happy because I deserve this fragrance. You know what I mean? So this one is. What is inside? No, that's fine. Okay. So there's a lot of ways to get a nice luxury product now, especially in fragrance. So I would say don't do that. It really not worth it, and it's not nice for the brand. And you, if you're a fragrance lover as well, you don't want to put you in that position. I mean, no. After I didn't try all the things, but not interested. So yeah, I'm quite glad I've tried this. I hope you liked the video. Obviously something very different. I do have another one that I've bought, and this is a lady scent. So I mean, if you kind of like me to try weird stuff, I will be very happy to try the ladies as well. And yeah, just tell me in the comments. Again, be kind to everyone. Yeah, there's no drama in here. And yeah, like, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you soon. Bye now.